Opportunities for people to kind of mingle around. There are going to be bar tables at the two ends of the rink, and it will be kind of a very nice social place to be. So those are just, I think we need to explain that a little bit to people to make them understand. Once they come once, they're going to see it, and I think that's where people are going to want to be, but for the first time, as I said, don't shy away from it. So we'll start first with people that aren't here today. I'm disappointed he wasn't able to make it because I think he may be the first to become a world champion in this group just because he's been at it longer. His name is Tarvis Marvelous Sims. He signed with Main Events recently and is a middleweight contender who we are trying to move into a title fight hopefully in the very near future. Tarvis is 26-1-1 with 11 knockouts. He will be fighting on the card. He wasn't able to make it today because of the trouble with transportation, but he'll certainly be here in Newark. Where do I start? Let's start with our newest Ice World fighter, and he is traveling here all the way from South Korea. His name is Dong-Chul Yun. Try. He has already made a name for himself in South Korea, and he is making his U.S. debut here against Joselito Colada. Dong does not speak English, but he has brought Jane Cho here with him to translate. So, Dong, would you like to speak?
He says thank you for coming here, number one, and also he wants to show you guys not a winning fight, but more of a exciting and more full fight, so that you guys can all, enjoy it more than him winning. So he says it's fine if he loses, but he wants everyone to be happy that he came and excited to see him again. He said that's
as he's called here in America, Howard has his hands taped. He's so ready to go. anyway, that should give you an idea of how anxious he truly is. On the other end of the table, we are going to bring up someone very close to our performer in the main event. This is one of Zab Judah's many brothers. This is Joseph Judah. Joseph is 5-1 with one knockout, and is, of course, from Brooklyn, and he is going to be making his first appearance on one of Zab's cards. Joseph Judah, would you like to say a word?
Yes. It's not my first appearance. I fought on Kaladi card. It's not my third.
Oh, sorry.
But
stand corrected.
I was looking for my opponent. He's not here?
No, he's not here today.
All right, well, I was here to talk to him, tell him what's going to happen. He's not here, so I'm going to just tell y'all what's going to happen. It's going to be a good night come March 5th. Definitely want to see me be there, check it out. My brother, the main event. I don't know, it might be the first, second fight, whatever, but get your tickets early because I'm going on early. And he's going out.
So, Greg Hackett of Chester, Pennsylvania, you've won a horn. Also not here today, by the way, is Joe Peralta of Jersey City. He's 4-1. He's also going to be appearing on the card. Next is another one of our Brooklyn boys, Shemuel Pagan. has fought a nice put in Prudential Center in August, July?
It was August, yes.
Where he won a very, very hard fought and tremendous fight. He is, of course, a former amateur standout from the New York Golden Gloves.
First and foremost, I'd like to thank God who blessed me with my talent and also allowed us to all make it here safely. Let's give a round of applause for that. I'd like to thank Main Events for giving me a second opportunity to come and shine and to showcase my talent once again. And this time, I will guarantee that I will perform better than the first time. Every fight, I will perform better. But I'd like to thank my supporters and fans out there, and everyone who, for all the video cameras, you can follow me on Facebook, Shemuel Pagan, at Twitter, DaKid, DaHKIID88. Thank you.
I'm gonna bring up a guy I told you about earlier. He's pro debuting. His name is Vinny O'Brien, and he is another kind of the opposite end of the spectrum from a guy like Tarvis Sims, who looks like he's on the brink of being able to fight for a world title, or the others here who someday will. We have Vinny, who is a local guy from New Jersey, and he came to us with his trainer, Louisa, not long ago, asking if he could work with us. He's a New Jersey Golden Gloves champion, and he will be making his pro debut against David Navarro on this card. And as I said earlier, I have two reasons. I want to bring Vinny up to talk about Vinny, but I also want to bring Lou up to talk about his role and the parallels that I see here. So who wants to go first? Vinny, or Vinny?
Kind of new to all this, and I just want to thank Main Events and everybody over there at Main Events for giving me this opportunity and this chance, especially in my own backyard. It's right in Newark, and it's definitely, I'm excited and anxious to get out there and show everyone around and my family, my friends, fans, and supporters what I could really do. And that's really what I, when I started boxing, what I wanted to do was, show the world what Daniel Bryan can bring into the ring. And at the end of the day, boxing can do a lot of things for me, but I want to do a lot of things for boxing. I want to bring class in. I want to go ahead and bring it back to the days where my mom used to be excited to see boxing fights. They also sit around on TV. So I want to be a fighter. I want to be a contender and hopefully world champion someday.
Hi, I'm Vinny O'Brien's trainer. I used to fight back in the day at Vice World. I used to fight out of Miami for the Dundees back then. And I used to come up here because I'm from New Jersey, and I fought a few times in the area. The prodigal son comes home, that type of thing. And Ice World did a lot for us. I mean, you got your chance. You're in front of so many people. And then when ESPN came in, it was off the hook. I mean, you're in the back actually vomiting, scared to death. You did the right thing when you came out. But I mean, it was really, really a lot of fun. And the Dubas did an unbelievable job. They took care of everyone. They made sure the opponents were right. They made sure everything was good. And now Kathy Duba has done the same thing. She's gonna may take it to the next level and do the same thing in this new venue, which I think is fantastic. They shortened the venue so that we don't have to sell 15,000 to 20,000 seats. So we can do our monthly or bi-month, whatever, every couple of months, we can have shows and these kids can get fights and they can be seen by the people and be built up and they can go places and they can, and with all your help, these fighters can make it. We bring boxing back. Right now boxing is a little bit of a low, but we can bring it back, and you guys got to help. You're here getting stories, write these stories, make the people see them, get them to buy tickets, get them to come to these shows. These kids deserve it. They're working hard, and you guys can do this for them. And I think Vinny O'Brien's going to be I mean, I'm not, you know, patting myself on the back because I'm his trainer. I'm saying you watch this kid, and you see his work ethics in the gym. He's off the hook. He's gonna. I think you're gonna be seeing a lot of him, and I think he's gonna grab a belt soon. I mean, I don't know about how soon, but it's gonna be soon. And come and support him. And as you can see, he's a good looking kid for now. See what happens down the road. I think you're all gonna like him. Just come back and see us at the fight. Okay.
When they came along and asked to take a film on the car. Just entertainment. It's beautiful. And Luke did point that I didn't, and that is that, you know, this first fight, we were very blessed to have a world championship fight at the top of the card. The way this happened was kind of unusual. We had a first bid, and there was a time limit, and the fight had to take place. There were no available dates in Prudential Center, and it kind of fell on us that we have to do this fight in a smaller venue. But in the future, we do intend to do more shows in the smaller venue. We can't do everything in Prudential Center with 20,000 or 10,000 seats or whatever we set it up for. It's just too big a venue for certain types of fights. And if young fighters have to wait until we have those big shows to get to be on undercards, they're not going to fight very often. So this is our going to be our incubator, our lab, where we're going to build up talent and give guys the kind of fights they need to develop and become great pros and not get rushed into fights they're not ready for, not be put in with stiffs who are going to fall down when they breathe on it. It's simply going to be a place where we can put guys in the kind of fights that they need to learn and grow and develop as pros so that they can become champions the way that list of names that I read to you earlier did, because that is exactly how they became champions. And we intend to basically follow that template and do it again. And this smaller venue gives us the opportunity to do that. And now to the co-feature. Got to know Sadam Ali very well recently. This will be his sixth appearance at Prudential Center. He has started out, as you know, another guy from Brooklyn, national junior Olympic champion. He was the U.S. Olympic team as a representative for the United States. Storied amateur career, and now making his way into the pros. He's got an 11-0 record with 6 knockouts right now. And again, you've seen 5 of those fights at the Prudential Center, and we're going to see his 12th fight there. And he is just everything that we'd ever hope to find, fighting on the undercard and building him up. Because he and his father David came to us a while ago, just like giving him a and said, come on, give us a chance. And we're very happy we did. And so I will give the tape before it's an honor.
There's a lot of Brooklyn fighting on this card, and I love to fight with a lot of friends that I have on the card. It's going to be very exciting. But first, I also want to thank God for having us all here and for having me so successful so far. And I'm looking forward to this fight myself. I'm excited to see it. I don't know if I'm going to be in the dressing room. I don't know if I can see everyone, but I would also like to see the undercard and of course the main event after my fight. I'm an exciting fighter. I like to excite the viewers. Everybody get their tickets, come out and watch. This is my 6th to 7th fight at the Prudential Center. I want to thank the Prudential Center and also thank Main Events for having me here. I'm excited and you see nothing but good at this fight. Thank you.
The fight, if you can't make it, will be on pay-per-view. Through Integrated Sports, Doug Jacobs is here with Integrated Sports. Check your local cable, satellite, or telco provider. It also will be available on Ustream for the same price, a new distributor that we have for this one, and there's going to be a lot of promotion on Ustream for this fight, so you want to start checking for that just as you're trying to start. Hopefully we'll get some stuff up there from today's press conference a little later today. And I want to thank again the Prudential Center for all they've done to bring boxing back and to help Main Events realize our vision. And also Brixie Bar and Grill for hosting us today. They did a wonderful job. And we'll see you on March 5th, if not sooner.
Can you make a pose a little tighter because this is a small space?
Sure, whatever you need.
What you talking about?